So I was messing around in the car, listening to old Christian metal, like 90s. The 90s had a lot of Christian rock and Christian metal. That was like a big time. And there was a church in California. I can't remember if it was San Diego or LA, but there was a church out there where a lot of these bands came from. And we used to call it the Rock and Roll Church. I can't remember the name, and I can't remember the exact place where it was. But I was just messing around in the car, and I was thinking, there's a lot of people on the internet that are really against this type of music. But when you really think about it, if you go way back, as music progresses, I mean, are you just going to have a cappella and introducing instruments was a sin, like back in the day, which technically isn't biblical, like to be against instruments? There's instruments mentioned all in the Bible, but you can see people like that that are very legalistic in that way, to where it gets to a certain point. But at the same time, it's not necessarily sinful to listen to this type of music. And I don't have a problem with anything as long as the lyrics are good. I do not want to listen to anything that's not promoting Jesus in some way or other. That's how I decide what to listen to. Yes, I still listen to secular music, but I listen to stuff like Joe Satriani. Now, he's a New Ager, he's not a Christian, but there's no lyrics in that music. I don't have a problem with that. I listen to a lot of Buckethead. There's no lyrics in his music. He's not a Christian, but it's very good music as a musician. I like stuff like that. I know I probably shouldn't listen to any secular music, but there's certain songs I don't have a problem with. But that's me. You might. That's your decision, you know. There are verses that say to that particular person, they view it as sin. And another person will view it as not sin because it's not necessarily defined. Now, yes, if this causes you to stumble, yes, then it is sin for me to do it and make you stumble. I personally don't have a problem with that. I do with you stumbling, but not listening to the music. When you learn things, you learn through music, like your ABCs. And if you're old enough to know the Schoolhouse Rock, you learned a lot of stuff through Schoolhouse Rock. I think that should still be in schools. Like, they should just use that in schools to learn numbers and, you know, your English stuff, like verbs and all that stuff, because that's all on there. You can learn a lot through this type of music. I've learned a lot of scriptures through this type of music. So I'm going to play a couple songs for you right now. You let me know. You tell me what you guys think of this type of stuff. I like this type of stuff. I come from a rock and roll background, a metal background, and when I first became a Christian, this is the type of stuff I was listening to, and I still enjoy this type of stuff. I don't have a problem with it as long as the lyrics are pretty biblical. So let me know your thoughts.
Interesting when his wife says, curse your God and let yourself be dead, is when you're reading it in the English, when what she actually said was, curse your God and die, but the way she says it is, curse your God and commit suicide. She actually tells Job to kill himself.